yeah, that's a little Black Lives Matter situation right here. So let me go on and get into the store. So y'all go get the coach fired like y'all usually do. You know the one too. A couple of African American cheerleaders was kicked off a cheerleading team at Ottawa University in Ottawa, Kansas. Now the news and the streets are a little bit disturbed by her claim. She was dismissed from refusing to take off her bonnet during cheerleading practice, and a woman believes that she's discriminated against because she's Black. She better go find Benjamin Crump real quick. He'll find her. You know how he do it. But she believes that she's been discriminated against because she's Black. So let me give you a little backstory on the cheerleader. Jefferson, she's a junior at Ottawa University, says she wore her bonnet to practice to prevent her from hitting a teammate in the face with an almost 3-foot-long box raise. Jefferson also followed up by telling the Kansas City Star that when she refused to remove it, the coach berated her in a racist rant. She got the practice and ultimately removed from the team. I smell a money dance right there, but it's not about the money, it's about the respect. Like, it's just like this. I got kicked off because I was standing up for myself against the microaggressive comments that my coach made towards me that made me and others feel uncomfortable. As you guessed, the university didn't take up for her with the coach, telling the coach that she was out of line and she made her feel uncomfortable as well as others. So when social media get a hold of this story, I'm sure they'll all be changing their tune. At that moment, they went along with the hate, and their solution was to kick her off instead. So I'm gonna give you a little clip of her story because she went on dragging it. Sister's like, because she said she don't understand, that's all she said, right? She said the coach got angry and hostile and started throwing her hands, saying that she don't understand, she don't understand, she do Black people there. She says, I'm a cosmetologist, and she said the very thing that they say, you know I'm not making about race, but she said, I lived with a Black girl for 5 years, and I understand what it's like to have hair like that. What? That wasn't enough. She went on to follow up by saying, you shouldn't have got 7-foot-long hair then. You know, sis was pissed right then, but she proceeded to listen to her tell her that her box braids are hindrance to her performance, and they are not collegiate, and she should have never got them in the first place. I know she was like, you ain't pay for these. All those comments she said to sis trying to make a spectacle out of her, right? She followed up with, get the fuck out of my practice, and then from there, she got up and walked over to her stuff while grabbing her stuff that she asked her friends. Like, do I sound crazy? Was I wrong for telling her that she don't understand? But you know what? I'm gonna cut her off right there because she went on with an essay on this shit. She gonna make sure they get her some fucking money and put some respect on her name. But they should, but people going fucking crazy. It's 2021. They don't wanna keep their hate in the fucking club. They feel they can say whatever the fuck they want to, which they can't. But with that being said, if you in the Kansas City area, don't send your kids to Ottawa. We see how they get down, so y'all hashtag everybody and let them know that we on our Black Lives Matter stuff like we always are.